Welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. Today we're going to be talking about paths. So paths are very similar to how on opportunities, actually I'm going to show you, how on opportunities we have this ribbon up here at the top that show us the stages and how far we are along the path of a opportunity. So paths are for other objects other than an opportunity to show us where we are on that particular record in an object. So that might not have made sense, but I have, as far as our use case goes, a projects object, and we have a field that is the status of the project, its planning, working, and closed. Very simple, but let's go ahead and hop into setup and type in path in the quick find. Go to path settings. And if you're doing this for the first time, you will need to click the enable button. It'll be green, but here we will just go to new path. So now we can choose the path name. I'm going to have this be for projects path. The API reference name is just going to be auto-generated. Choose an object. This is going to be projects. You can see the other objects that we can use for this. Then you'll have to choose the record type. I'll go to marketing and the pick list that you want your path to be based off of. Again, I did create statuses, which is misspelled, but that's another point. Previously, before doing this tutorial, you could do it on the type, but the type of project isn't necessarily what we want visualized in our path. So again, create that field beforehand if you need to create that field. I'll hit next. And then we can provide guidance for each of these. So if we're working on a planning section of our project, we want to have the user stories completed and user stories assigned. All right, so that seems like a good path guidance. Let's go ahead and hit next. Excuse me, go back. Next, we'll work on working. So what working will be is the completing of the user stories or completing the tasks of the user stories. User stories being what we want to accomplish to finish our project. All right, and then we'll go to closed. User stories have been completed and tested. All right, so now that we have that there, I will hit next. I will activate this path and then enable celebrations, which has confetti for whichever pick list values. I'm gonna select all, that's fun. And then we can choose celebration frequency. It may be rarely, sometimes, often, or always. I always want to have confetti. I will select finish. And there you go. That is how you create a custom path for your users to work through the different object that you want them to work path. I believe that projects will probably be the most, or one of the most frequent use cases for using a path or leads or other custom objects. If you have any questions about paths, be sure to drop them down below in the comment section. I'll try to get back to you as soon as possible. If you have any other video ideas, be sure to also drop them down below so I can add it to my list of videos. If you found this helpful, be sure to give it a like, subscribe. I'd really appreciate it. Check out the courses down below. And if you would like to subscribe to my email list, you can do so at salesforceemily.com. Thank you so much, and I will catch you in the next one.